Now to the topic of energy. Viewer Patrick from Thibodeau asks, how would you suggest reconciling a need for energy sustainability with Louisiana's current role in oil and gas resources? And what measures would you support for coastal restoration? We start again with Mr. Spears.
Ooh, that's a tough one. That's a mouthful. I think, you know, Louisiana, one of our primary industries is the energy industry. And I'm all for green energy sources. But let me tell you this right now. Our primary source is fossil fuels in this country, and we import a significant amount of it. And what concerns me about that is the fact that if for some reason there was another embargo, if for some reason that it became a military issue, then we would be in big trouble, simply because we wouldn't have the energy to fuel the needs of a war and just the basic needs of our country. I think that in terms of restoring our coast, it's up to Louisiana, the government of Louisiana, to establish what's needed.
Mr. Melanson.
Well, having been a supporter of the oil and gas industry, having been the person who passed an amendment to lift the moratorium, having grown up in the marshes of South Louisiana, concerned about coastal restoration for many, many years, and taking an active part, we can't get to green tomorrow. And we've got to find something that's a balance between drill, baby, drill, and a moratorium that is safe so that the people of South Louisiana never have to worry about getting up again to a BP explosion type situation that caused us all havoc and for years I think will haunt us in our marshes and coastland. We need to invest. The state has set up by constitutional amendment a fund and it has a plan for restoration. We need to funnel as much money as quickly as we can. I did that with my amendment in the bill just before we adjourned. That will move $1.2 billion into coastal restoration funds from the fines and penalties.
Mr. Vitter.
Well, Norman, I adopt the common sense of Louisianians and Americans. It's not either or, either traditional oil and gas or new renewable energy. It's all of the above, and we need to do all of the above aggressively to get out of our energy hole, and I've supported those policies. In terms of coastal restoration, let me tell you what I've done. Early on in my career in the Senate, I went to the committee that deals with core projects. I helped rewrite a water resources bill. We rewrote that bill so that instead of only 4 coastal restoration projects in Louisiana, we authorized 17. Instead of only $450 million, we authorized $8 billion. And then when President Bush vetoed that bill, I got 21 Republicans to vote with me to override that veto for Louisiana.
Thank you, Mr. Wooten.
Well, representing what I do in the Louisiana legislature, it's all coastal. Plaquemine Parish, Barataria-Lafitte. Oil is very, very important to my district. We need to continue it, but we also need to study and find ways, cleaner energy, to cut down on the foreign imports. Now, in a two-part question, coastal restoration, I've been fighting that for 30 years before I was ever in politics. We had an organization called Plaquemine Improvement Committee, and we went to the state. We did our own study. We went to the state. We got things started. It's a tragedy to see what's happened to the marsh in Plaquemine Parish, what the people have lost, and the danger we face from hurricanes.
Thank you. Mr. Hayes.
Government should not favor one type of energy and industry over another. The government should just let the free market work. Again, just stay out of the way. And if alternative fuel sources are the smart way to go, I think the free market will select for that. It may take a while. Things work better if you have time to let the people decide. Let the market decide. What works best, rather than imposing any sort of government regulations that favor or disfavor any particular energy source.
Thank you. Mr. McShann.
I agree. I'm all of the above. We cannot just completely stop using oil today. We have to have it for our industries to work. But we can start developing solar panels that would be efficient, wind turbines that would make sense to build. The subsidies we have now for corn on ethanol, it's not working. So, but we need to drill, We need to develop the solar panels. We need to develop wind energy. And we need to weatherize the houses also, make the houses more efficient. But we have to do them all and get the government off the back of the oil companies so they can explore deep water or the oil shales, stuff like that.
Thank you. Candidates, we're coming down the home stretch. We have 30 seconds for the next two questions. Turning to education and the topic of charter schools. It seems the new mantra for solving the public education problem is charter schools. Yet critics say these schools are selective, leaving many of the undereducated and those with special needs behind. Do you agree that charter schools is the answer? Why or why not? Congressman Melanson, we start with you.
Well, I don't see them working in every instance. So maybe we have to set up some status or standards that's there so that we can assure that there's quality education. I've stood up for better education. I'll stand up for trying to fund education because what's happened in the state right now as we speak, what's happened in this country, we've now dropped to number 11 or 12 in the world for educating our kids, and that will take us to the bottom quicker than anything. We need to make sure that we are investing in education, and I will continue to make that effort.
Thank you. Mr. Vitter.
Norman, I don't think charter schools are the answer. I do think they are a big answer, and I strongly support them. The great news is Louisiana is the leading laboratory for charter schools with 70 charter schools in our state, many, many more than any other state. Now, I disagree with Charlie. I don't think we should have either a congressman or a bureaucrat deciding what schools to allow or disallow. I think we should give parents choice. I think we should empower parents and families and let them decide because nobody cares about their child more than that child's parents.
Thank you. Mr. Wooten.
My wife's a retired teacher of 33 years. And I, too, think that charter schools need to be looked at, but public education in this country needs to be looked at. It's failing us. You know, we went 20, 30 years ago, we wanted to make everybody a rocket scientist, and now we got rocket scientists that can't read and write when they're coming. We need to go back to basics, whether it be charter or public. We need to teach people to read, write, and do some math when they get out. They can go to a community college system, or they can go to college, whichever.
Thank you. Mr. Hayes.
Parents do need to be given as much choice as possible in how their children are going to be educated. Charter schools are one type of school that they should have the option of trying. But there are all sorts of other things too. I don't think though that the federal government should be regulating education. I just don't think that there's anything in the Constitution that allows that to happen.
Thank you, Mr. McChan.
I think there's a place for charter schools. They've been shown with less money to be able to get better scores. But I think that should be a parent's prerogative. And it should be a state prerogative. Agree with Mr. Hayes, it's not a federal government program. When the No Child Left Behind is leaving children behind every day. So we need to take the Department of Education, remove it, and put it back to the states and let them control how the state is going to educate their children.
Thank you. Mr. Spears.
It's one of the things that scares me about returning control of our school systems to the states. And this is one good case in Louisiana. I don't believe charter schools are the answer. And here's why. Because a charter school is removed from local purview. A charter school is operated by the state government. A charter school takes away the ability for parents and teachers to have a say-so through elected school board officials. Now, and it hasn't been proven that charter schools are more effective. Where the problem is we need a more contemporary model of education, not the old factory model where teachers stand up and deliver content to kids in a schoolroom.
Thank you. Our last question in this segment comes from the National Council of Jewish Women. Louisiana has the highest rate of death by gunfire in the country, nearly double the national rate. What regulations do you think should be put in place to bring these statistics down? Senator Vitter, this round begins with you.
Well, Norman, obviously that involves gun control, the question, and I am completely, unalterably opposed to gun control. And whether you think it's a good idea or a bad idea, it just happens to be unconstitutional because we have a Second Amendment. Thank goodness the Supreme Court has verified that in a very strong way in a recent ruling. I'm very proud to have the endorsement in this race of the NRA. I'm very proud to have the endorsement of this race of Gun Owners of America. Now, there's a problem with violence, but it's a criminal justice problem, a criminal problem, not a gun problem per se.
Mr. Wooten.
Well, y'all might know me as the gunman in the legislature. I am totally against gun control. Guns don't kill people. You can put a gun at that table right there and leave it there for months, and it's not going to kill anybody. Society needs to change. The family unit needs to be repaired. But we do not need gun control. You know, I hate to stand here and agree with Mr. Vitter two questions in a row. You know, that really doesn't do my heart good, but... Well, you know, we do not
Ernest,
in any
if
way
you think you feel bad
control.
About it.
Yeah, but you're not standing next to a hypocrite. I am.
Mr. Hayes.
I don't think that you're going to find anybody here tonight who's going to say they support gun control, and I certainly don't. The Constitution wouldn't allow it, and it wouldn't be good for society, so there are no restrictions on guns that I would support.
Mr. McShann.
I would not either. I believe the Second Amendment ought to be strengthened to prevent challenges to it. So, no, the best way we can prevent violence is through local officials and a strong family unit. And that's the only way that crime's going to be reduced. Thank you.
Mr. Spears, did you answer the question?
I won't bore the audience with the same old answer. Ditto.
Mr. Malonzo.
I've got an A rating with NRA, and I've hunted and fished all my life, unlike Mr. Vitter, who's never had a hunting and fishing license in the state. But let me go back to talking about state control. Mr. Vitter voted for No Child Left Behind, which was a mandate to schools throughout this country to do something, but underfunded it by $8 billion. He went to private school. Not everybody's lucky enough to do that. I wish we could afford to do that. But it's about educating our kids and moving them forward. And he voted for the largest cut in history for student loan programs.
Thank you. Since you took the last shot at him, I'm going to give him 20 seconds. We're going to move to the rapid fire round after this, but I'm going to give you 20 seconds.
Then I get to say that he doesn't match up, his record doesn't match up to all the bragging.
Mr. Vitter.
Norman, I don't know where to start. I mean, we can start
quickly. You only got
20
seconds.
Trivial as hunting fishing license, which I have right now and have had in the past. It just shows how many inaccuracies are flying out of here at the same time.
All right, gentlemen, thank you. Now time for our final round, in which the candidates will be asked a series of yes or no questions and a series of questions requiring an answer in the form of a letter grade from A to F. Beginning with Mr. Wooten. Yes or no, should gays be allowed to serve openly in the military?
Yes.
Mr. Hayes. Mr.
No.
McShann.
No.
Yes.
Mr. Vitter.
No.
All right, beginning first now with Mr. Hayes. On a scale of A to F, how would you grade the state's education system?
I would say C minus.
C minus. Mr. McShann.
D.
D? Did you say D?
D.
All right. Mr. Spears?
C.
Mr. Malonzo?
I'm not a teacher, but it's pretty poor.
You give it a grade?
I'm not a teacher. I don't grade very well, but I would say it's below par.
How would you grade Mr. Vitter?
That's already down at the bottom.
Okay. Mr. Vitter?
Say it used to be D. I'd say C minus now.
All right. Mr. Wooten?
I'm not going to agree. I was going to say C minus, but I'll say C.
Mr. Hayes, did you give us a grade? Yes, you did. All right, starting with Mr. McShann. Yes or no, former Soviet President Mikhail Gorbachev, who pulled out of Afghanistan after 20 years of losses, says a victory there is impossible and that America is risking another Vietnam if we stay. Is he right?
No.
No.
Mr. Spears, Mr. Malonzo?
I'm ambivalent there. I've got frustrations on both sides. So do we win, and what do we win? So... right now, it's probably a no.
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 Yes.
Right. Beginning with you, Mr. Spears, on a scale of A to F, how would you grade race relations right now in the United States?
C minus.
Mr. Malonzo.
Poor.
Mr. Vitter.
C minus.
Mr. Wooten.
D.
B minus.
Mr. McShann.
B.
Right. Beginning with Mr. Malonzo. Yes or no, should learning to speak English be required to become an American citizen?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Yes.
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 Beginning with Mr. Vitter, on a scale of A to F, How would you grade the fairness and current implementation of the death penalty?
I really don't have all the facts in front of me, but I would say B.
Mr. Wooten?
B plus.
C.
B.
B.
C.
Above average.
Above average? All right. Yes or no? Would you support a tax increase to address the nation's crumbling infrastructure? We'll just go quickly. Mr. Spears?
No.
Mr. Melosa?
No.
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 Thank you, gentlemen. That completes our rapid fire round. And now,